Hey everybody, Johnny B. Good here. Good afternoon. Greetings from somewhere around Kansas City, Kansas. All right, the local time here, it is 12:25 p.m. Temperature is a beautiful 81 degrees. Once again today, it is Tuesday, September 22nd, 2015. Not exactly in Kansas City, but somewhere in that neighborhood. Clay Como, maybe? We'll have to wait until alright, here we are. City limit, Pleasant Valley. There you go. Pleasant Valley, Missouri. By the looks of things, we are going to be spending a 10-hour break somewhere, probably in Guymon, Oklahoma tonight. We have 7 hours and 55 minutes remaining to drive. Check out that tanker. That's a beautiful Peterbilt right there. Looks like it's been lowered a little bit. Pretty cool. Interesting, the city of Clay Como. All right, just a little bit of a recap. We are loaded about 30,000 pounds of Belgioso cheese. We are bound for City of Industry, California. Picked this load up in Green Bay, Wisconsin yesterday. All right, got a comment question or a question comment from one of you. What happens if I was to go to a truck stop and the parking lot was full and I completely ran out of hours? Well, you keep circling around, around, circle, around parking lot until you find one. But if you really don't, if a parking is not available, even though you're completely out of hours, you can go back on duty, not driving. No, you can go to driving again. Put yourself on a driving status, even though you're completely out of hours, and you write a comment, parking lot full, looking for safe haven, so you go to the next truck stop, or the next available safe haven. You just gotta make sure you put a comment why you left. And when you get there, before you go off duty, to put safe haven on the comment section. They would still put you in a violation, but chances are they will not give you a ticket for it. Now, of course, you can't do that all the time, otherwise they will they will start looking at your pattern and say, oh, you must have the worst luck in the world. You keep driving past your 11-hour looking for safe havens, which I would imagine some drivers do. I suppose you can get away with it once in a while, but you keep doing it. It's to the officer's discretion. And also your safety e-log department. Which is really not all that uncommon, especially you're out there in New Jersey, New York, around the turnpike area. I mean, if you're not pulled over at the turnpike by 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you're pretty much screwed. So, the longest I've ever used safe haven over the 11-hour mark was about 45 minutes, because there was absolutely nothing. And when I came to the office, logbook department looked at me like, Johnny, are you feeling all right? By the way, a grateful thanks and gratitude to all of you who have written comments and shared and liked my videos. I appreciate that very, very much. I will try to continue to strive to share with you the life on the road for truck drivers in this beautiful country. And ultimately, it is God's creation, glorifying the Lord Jesus Christ 1 mile at a time. City limit, North Kansas City. There you go. Welcome to Kansas, everybody. Well, we'll catch you guys later. Sorry, I'm in a quiet mood. Thanks for watching. Have a good and godly day, everyone. Peace.